Hi, everyone. Welcome to day 17 of the holiday card series for 2021. I have a really fun card planned for you tonight, and I'm hoping it works out because it's got a little bit of an interactive element to it. I'm going to have like a little, it's going to flap up, it's going to have a flap that comes up and have the greeting inside. I'm hoping it works. I think it will. We're going to find out if it works. So hello to everyone in the chat. Hello, hello, so many of you tonight. Thanks for joining me. I'm glad you're here. The products I'm using in today's video are mostly from Concord and Ninth. Let me switch to my overhead. Here we go. So I've got, oh, look at my cute plaid nails. Aren't they cute? They're matte. I'm getting used to them. I love it. I painted them myself and then did nail stamping on top. So that's kind of fun. Research nail stamping. If you've never seen it before, it's a game changer. I've been doing it for like a decade. It's kind of fun. Okay, so I'm gonna put up my sleeves here so I can get going here. This is the Fa La La Fringe Tree stamp set and die set from Concord and Ninth. This came out in September, and I've wanted to try making a Christmas tree card with it ever since. So tonight is the night. Okay, so I have a basic plan of what I want it to be. So this is what the front of the card's gonna look like, basically. But the plan is that this tree is going to be its own die cut, and it's gonna have a fold up at the top, and then it like flips open. And stamped on the tree inside will be this, May Your Merry Be Very, because it's like the perfect size to go on the tree. It was a little too perfect to pass up. I really, really wanted to try it. Oh, I just realized I'm not wearing my wedding ring. Sorry, I washed my hands earlier, and I don't like to wash my hands a ton while I'm wearing it. So anyway, still married. Okay, so let's get going here. The first thing we're going to do is a little bit of stamping. And here's the die set, too. And we're going to stamp on this green cardstock from Concord and Ninth. This is Clover cardstock. And I'm actually going to cut the main tree image out of it too. So I want to make sure I have enough room, you know, when I die cut it to have it fold in half. So it's going to be right here, and it's going to have to, you know, fold in half that way. So in fact, you know what, just to be safe, why don't I do this? Because it should have plenty of room vertically. I'm just going to make a little pencil mark, and I'm going to trim this down in my trimmer. So I'll have two pieces of cardstock to work with. So it looks like I need about 3 1/8. Maybe a little less than that, because in fact, you know what? That might not work, because I've got to stamp this other stuff. Oh, we're fine. We'll make it work. I've got another piece of green cardstock here we can work with anyway. All right. You know, since we're worried about it, let's just go ahead and get this die cut taken care of now. I'm going to score my cardstock. I don't have no idea what this is, if it's going to be in half or not, but we'll just do that. It was not directly in half, but that's okay. All right, and then when I put this die on here, I'm gonna have it just hang off the top just a little bit. And that's going to give me the fold I need so that it's like a flap on the front of the card. All right. Now this Concord and Ninth cardstock is, I believe it's only 80 pounds, so it should probably cut through without any trouble at all. If it was 100 pound or 110 pound, I might have to run it through a couple of times. All right, here's my die cutting sandwich. And we'll just run this right through. Okay. Yeah, that cut beautifully. All right. carefully take that tape off. And now we have a little tree that can fold up. How cute. I love that. Okay, so we'll be assembling our stamped and die cut tree on top of this folded one. All right, so we can move the die back over here. Set that aside, and we're going to do some stamping. All right, I'm going to get out my Misty. Let me zoom out just a little bit here for you so you can see what I'm doing. Okay, got that same green cardstock in my Misty, and I'm going to stamp the tree elements on the green. And it's actually just in two big pieces. And when you die cut them, you die cut them together. All right, I'll just stamp it just like that. And I'm going to use the same color of ink as the cardstock. So it's going to have a tone on tone effect. Okay. I love this green. It's so great. Do I want to stamp it one more time? No. Well, actually, yes, I think I will. Just to get a really even impression. One part looked just a little splotchy. Perfect. I'll clean this off with my stamp chamois. I love Concord inks. They clean off so easy. Alrighty, let's see. That's that one. And that one. All right, I'm going to trim this down just a little bit before I put it through my die cutting machine. And the rest of this, except for when we stamp on the actual tree, is going to be die cutting. Hold on, let me zoom in here again. Okay. So now we're going to come back to the dies. And if you notice, they're all together. Isn't that fun? So I can line this one up just right. I'll hold it with some EZC tape. Someone in the comments has just mentioned that my stamp chamois was prepped. I am notorious for forgetting to do that. So the thing that has saved me is the salt cellar from, well, you can get it on Amazon, but I got mine from Simus Stamp. But basically you can like keep your moistened stamp chamois in the container and then close it up and it doesn't get moldy. It doesn't get gross. The outside gets ink on it from my fingertips, but it wipes off clean later. Anyway, I've had my stamp chamois in this for up to a week and it doesn't dry out. So this one, I think I wet yesterday. So anyway, that's a tip. I'll try to remember to put it in the supply section when I do the supplies. All right, so here's the other one. Notice on the image that there are blank gaps. Those are for the ornaments. Okay, it's a little off, but I think we're okay. And I'm gonna do some other die cutting at the same time. So I might as well slide that over. Okay, I need the star, and I'm also going to have the fa-la-la in the same color of gold cardstock. So the gold shimmer paper I'm using is from Memory Box. This is the Majestic Hues Glitter Pad. I used this for a different card earlier. I don't remember which one it was, but I wanted something really sturdy. If you remember back from my little sketch here, the fa-la-la is going to go off the edge of the tree. So I wanted it to have a really sturdy glitter paper so that it's not going to get all flimsy with the areas that are hanging off the sides. And this shimmering cardstock, it cuts really well, but it's pretty sturdy. So I thought that would be a good compromise. All right, so I'm just going to, I think I'll cut this. And I can probably get that star here at the end too, right there. And then for the red, I'm actually using a little bit of red glitter paper from Lawn Fawn. This was left over from my card on Monday. And I'm just gonna cut a little square out of it, just enough for all of the ornaments. So these can go right there. And then we do need a trunk. So, you know, I think I'm gonna stamp the trunk because it's gonna go underneath the tree. So I think I'll just stamp it in a nice brown ink and call it good. All right, run this through my die cutting machine. Oh, Christy, thank you for the super chat. Thank you so much. For those of you who missed it last week, we discovered what a super chat is, which you can hit that little money sign. And it's like leaving me a tip. You don't need to, but thank you so much. I appreciate it. It helps me buy more and more crafting supplies. Okay, so let's see. Where'd my die thing go? I have no idea where these go, but that's okay. And then we want our little tree pieces. Ugh, these are so cute. Okay. Now we get to assemble our tree. You know, before we do that, I think it would be wise to stamp on the inside. You know, just in case there's a problem. So I'm going to go ahead and stamp this. And just put that magnet right there. And it says, "May your Mary be very." I think it's such a cute little saying. And it fits perfectly on the little tree. Look how cute. May your Mary be very. I think you could also do this. Okay, this is a good idea. If you had a family photo where everyone fit in like a triangle, maybe there's like, you know, three people in the photo or, you know, smaller group, you could actually have your family photo like on this portion. So you open the flap and there's your family photo. Adorable. I think that would be really, really cute. All right. I think I'm going to heat emboss this. So I'm going to use my anti-static powder tool and Versamark ink. So I've got Versamark right here. I'm just going to ink it up. I've got my stamp. It's not leveled. There we go. Ink up the stamp. And press that down. Looks beautiful. And white embossing powder. Got a little embossing powder just kind of sticking to this few little areas. So I'm just going to sweep it away with a clean paintbrush. And generally after you do that, then you can tap the back of your cardstock and it gets any remaining powder to kind of fall off. Perfect. I'm going to switch to the low setting on my heat tool just so I can prevent lots of working. It does take a little longer to heat emboss though. Someone's asking what this little triangular scoop is. Studio Katya sells some. It's called a triangle tray. I think a couple beading companies do as well. Okay. Oh, that's so cute. I love that. All right. Let me find my remote so I can zoom in and we're going to start assembling this. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to start with the bottom layer, which I believe is going to go right on top. In fact, I think, let's see, how are these going to, I'm trying to figure out if I want to have them popped up on foam tape or not. I don't think I do. I think it's going to be pretty bulky with the double layer anyway, so I'm not going to do that. But I am going to use a liquid glue on the back of this and just dab a couple little spots. And that'll give me a little time to wiggle things around. Okay. The next piece up is this one. Make sure I have glue up there. And I'm just lining up the two corners. There we go. And that glue, it dries clear, so it'll be perfect. Okay, and then the next piece up. Once again, I'll just line up the two sides and glue that down. And then I'll have to cut off the top of this one so that I'm able to fold up the tree, but I'll wait to do that until I have it glued down. All right, and lining up the two sides once again. Okay, so if it was going to stay perfect like that, we could leave it, but since we want to encourage the recipient to fold it up, to see how this section would get in the way. I'm going to have it centered on my card. If you wanted to, you could just have the tree be at the very top of your card. It would totally work. But I want to have the tree in the center of the card. So I'm going to just snip off the top. Just like that. Not a huge deal. All right, let's put some ornaments on our little tree. And I'm going to use my paintbrush here to poke out all the little circles. There we go. I love that they have the gaps so you know exactly where you want to put your ornaments because it's going to make it super easy. So I'm just going to put a little dab of glue. It's not going to dry so fast that I won't be able to get them on here in time. So then I can just pick up, well, that is if I can get them picked up. They're hard to pick up with tweezers. So I'm just gonna pick them up with my fingers. I love this. I have done a lot of traditional colored Christmas cards in the series this year. And I'm loving it. I'm just loving the traditional colors. Okay. All right, before we adhere this to the card front, I need to do some stamping, so I've got to get the position of the tree just right. I wanted to stamp tree trunk. So I'm going to go back to my Misty, get this stuff out of the way. All right, back to my Misty. And I'm going to get the greeting out of my Misty over here. It is really stuck down. Okay. All right. And if you wanted to, like, the stamp set has all of the ornaments spaced perfectly so you could stamp it directly on top. It's a really versatile stamp set, especially if you have the dies as well. So I think I'm going to do this smaller tree trunk. And I'm also going to grab a card front. I'm just going to have a regular white card front. And I think I'll have it be top folding too. Okay. So here's my card front. My tree is going to go right there in the center. And I need a space for the star as well. Let's get the star punched out just so we can see exactly where it will be. So the star will be right there. And we need room for the tree trunk. So just kind of moving it up just a little bit. And then I have no idea what direction this trunk is supposed to go. I don't know that it really matters. But, okay, right there. That's about where the tree trunk will be. Let's pick that up. Got to go over to my wall of inks and pick out a brown, a really nice brown. Concord and Ninth, they have mushroom, but it's like a warm gray. I'm going to pick Mocha from Simon Says Stamp. Never used this color. Looks like a nice brown though. Put that right there. And then I also wanted to use some of the little sparkle images from the stamp set. These little guys. I wanted to put that like kind of around the tree. I'm trying to decide if I want to do it now, if I want to do it. You know, I will stamp all that after because I think I'll end up using just a regular acrylic block for that anyway. Oh my word, more super chats. You guys are amazing. I'm so sorry if I missed more. I just saw one from Julie. Thank you, Julie. Okay, let's get this adhered down. Oh, this is going to be so stinking cute. It reminds me of just like a Charlie Brown Christmas tree. I love it so much. Okay, I think I'm going to put regular Tombow adhesive on the back of the Christmas tree. Just because I want it to stay really, really flat. And we'll put our little tree right there. I love that. And then, oh, so cute. Okay. I've got my little star. I will use a liquid glue for the star. Now, if you wanted to leave your card like this, I think you could definitely do a card like this, not have the flap, just have the die cut tree. And I think it'd be adorable. Okay. And now we have our fa-la-la that can go right on top. And I'm glad I used this thicker glitter paper because I think it's really going to hold up well. Just getting it away from that. Oh yeah, that is going to be so dang cute. Let's see here. I'm going to use my craft pick. And we're going to zoom in here. All Lovely. All right, so now I'm going to take note of the area that's directly over the tree. It looks like it's going to be half of the first A through the beginning of the second A with none of that L, if that makes sense. I've got a little thing right there. Okay, so because I only want to put adhesive on the areas that are going to be touching the tree. Okay, so the last half of the A, all of this one, all of that one, and the bottom part of that L. Okay. Lovely. I'm just going to hold that in place for a moment. And I'm going to come over here and look at the little glisteny things. I was thinking of having them in like a pale blue. I think that might look nice. Go ahead and peel that up off the... There we go. Okay, I think that's totally... Oh, I love that. It's a little bit dainty because it's a really small fold up here, but I still think it's pretty awesome. Okay. I'm going to get an acrylic block. This one looks good. And I'm going to use sea glass ink from Concord and Knight. And I can just come in here and stamp a few little glistens. Can you see that? So cute. And then I can lift the tree out of the way. I'm just kind of going all around. Okay. You know what? I almost kind of liked it without the little glisteny stamps. So you could definitely skip this step if you wanted to recreate this card. I haven't done just some like random stamping with an acrylic block in ages. It's kind of fun. Okay. Oh my word, that's the card for today. Hello? That was so fast. 28 minutes. That is crazy. Okay, that's bugging me up there. There's like a little spot that needs a little glisten. There we go. Ta-da! Super fast and easy. It folds up. Love that. So much. Oh, we have a troll. Someone probably already grabbed it, but all right. I banned them. I didn't know. Okay. I don't know if someone had already banned them or not, but I just banned them. Okay. So this is the card for today. I'm going to do a quick spiel for those watching the edited replay, and then we'll get into the after show. I'm not sure what we're doing today, but We'll do some fun. We'll talk and we'll chat. So this is day 17 for the holiday card series. I hope you guys enjoyed this really simple interactive card. So many different like tree die cuts or other little shape die cuts that you have in your stash could work with something like this, where you just add a fold at the top and then you could have it on the front. Thank you, Lori, for the super chat. You guys are amazing. Lori says, thanks so much for your videos. They always brighten my day. Oh, that's so sweet. Thank you so much. You know, I'm so sad that I missed any of the other super chats. So I'm going to go back through here and highlight them in just a minute. I got sidetracked from saying my little spiel for the edited replay. My mind is just fleeting today. Okay, we're going to redo it. So this is the finished card for day 17 of the holiday card series. I hope you guys enjoyed. This little flap element could be created with a bunch of other dies that you might have in your stash. I think it'd be really pretty with an ornament, like a circular ornament. That might even be a better shape if you wanted the interior to be, you know, like a picture of your family or whatever. I think it'd be really, really beautiful. Thanks for joining me today. Down in the comments, I want you to answer a holiday question. In last week's edited video for the live stream, you were like, hey, where's the holiday question? So here's a holiday question for you. And now is when I think about it. And then I splice out the part where I'm thinking, and then I have a question. Those of you watching it live are getting a behind the scenes look at what I do at the end of these videos. Okay. Holiday treats are always a good question. If you guys have a question suggestion, let me know in the comments. Wow. Okay. How about this? Okay. So there is kind of a widely known tradition with Christmas pajamas. I'm wondering if you guys participate in that. Do you do Christmas pajamas with your family or, you know, anything like that? And also, when do you wear the Christmas pajamas? My cousin just changed their tradition from opening their Christmas pajama presents on Christmas Eve. She changed it to Thanksgiving. So now they have the entire time between Thanksgiving and Christmas to wear their Christmas pajamas. I thought that was such a cute little change in tradition. So let me know, do you participate in the Christmas pajama tradition? And let me know about your tradition in the comments. Thanks for watching. I will see you guys on Friday for day 18 of the holiday card series. Okay, we are in the after show. And I'm going to go back and I'm going to find all those other super chats. Okay. So Julie Lynn, thank you so much. Your profile picture is beautiful, by the way. Thank you so much, Julie Lynn. Okay, I'm scrolling. Let's see here. Oh, and here's the one that started it with Christy. Love you. I love Christy. I know Christy. She went on my crafty cruise a few years ago. I don't know. I think she may have been the first one. I need someone like, you know, someone here in the room with me watching to make sure I don't miss any super chats. You guys are a chatty bunch today going through all these comments. Okay. Now I'm going back down. Okay. Oh, you did Christmas pillowcases. Oh, I love that. That is such a good tradition. More comments on my nails. Thank you. I'm loving that. You know what? I saw a picture on Pinterest with like some red and black plaid nails, and they had done a matte top coat. And I was like, I don't think I need to do that. I've never been big on matte top coats on my nails, but I'm kind of digging it now. Oh, let's see. I think I've caught up. If you have any questions, let me know. So sorry about all the trolls that kind of came in today. Let's see here. Okay. Oh, that sounds fun. Red and black plaid onesie with my husband. We started it last year. That sounds so fun. Let's see here. Yvette says, I buy each of my kids and grandkids matching PJs every year. I love that. I think it's such a fun tradition. When do you take down your Christmas tree? That is a good question. I'm going to remember that. Watch for that soon. Okay, Eileen says, I'm wanting a custom logo stamp to be made to stamp the back of my handmade cards. Do you have a favorite custom stamp maker? I know a lot of people like Jossy Bossy. I can't remember. I think it's just bossy.com is her website. If you already have the logo done, you already have the artwork, you've created it, you already know what you want. SimonStamp.com actually, they can make a red rubber stamp for you. I've done that in the past. I'm trying to think. I don't know of any other ones that will do a custom stamp for you like that. But Bossy Jossy, let me find a post-it to write on. I believe it's spelled like this. I think. But I think it's just bossyjossy.com or something like that. That will help you start the search. What's the name of the triangles? Of the triangle tray? It was Triangle Tray, and it's from Studio Katya. How often do you change your nail color? Well, it used to be that I would repaint my nails about every 4 or 5 days, because that was about the amount of time that I could have them without any big, like, chips or anything. But I resisted it for years, but I've since moved to gel polish. And with gel polish, I can do the initial gel painting, and it lasts 2 to 3 weeks. But after 1 week, it starts to show that it's growing out. So then I just paint over the top with regular polish. And it wears just as well. It doesn't chip at all because it's on top of the gel polish. So it saved me some time, and I don't have to worry about my nails chipping as much. So that's kind of good. I saw a super chat come in while I was chatting from IRC. I'm a big Christina fan. Who isn't? Oh, that's so sweet. Thank you. Oh, this is a really good tip. Search Etsy also for custom stamps. That's a great tip. I didn't even think about that. Oh, it's Bossy Jossy. There we go. Bossy is the regular spelling at the beginning. Okay. Perfect. Oh, this is a tough situation. I was a caregiver to my parents for many years, but they are now both gone and I'm on my own. So I need to figure out my own traditions. I don't know if you're a big reader, you know, of fiction or nonfiction or anything, but I know there is a tradition in, I believe it's in Iceland, where they get a new book on Christmas and they read a book. And I think that's such a lovely tradition that could be something that you want to incorporate into your regular festivities. You know what? Maybe it's about buying yourself some pajamas, something like that. Or maybe you can have a tradition that's centered around serving others. Maybe it's, you know, going to a soup kitchen and serving those in your community, or putting together gift baskets, or sponsoring like a child for like a giving tree. Like we in our area, we have like, I think they just call it the giving tree, where they have kids in the community that aren't necessarily going to have any presents for Christmas, or they need necessities, you know, like socks and clothing and coats and boots and things like that. And so they have different ornaments on the tree, but the ornaments are just like a little informational card on the child, and you take the ornament off the tree, and then that means you've committed to buying gifts for that child, and then you just bring it back to the store where the tree was at, and they make sure it gets to the child that for Christmas. So there might be some programs like that in your area. You could turn that into a tradition. I love traditions where it's like you're making something to give to someone else. So maybe make treats for neighbors, listening to holiday music or holiday movies. My mom and I have a tradition. We haven't done it yet this year, but we usually, it's like a Saturday or Sunday, probably a Sunday. We have a really nice breakfast and we sit down in front of the TV and we watch White Christmas, the original Bing Crosby, Rosemary Clooney. Such a fun movie. It's one of my favorites. So we do that every year. We also somehow always watch You've Got Mail, which is not a holiday movie at all. But there is a scene when they're at a holiday party. So that there's that. let's see here. Let's see here. I'm looking for, oh, good tip. Search Simon Says Stamp for bead tray. A few come up. Yes. It's called a bead tray or a triangle tray. Either of those terms will work. Do you change the theme of your Christmas tree each year? No, not really. I've had the same Christmas tree ornaments. Well, we have two trees. One, I always only had one tree, but since I have room in my craft room this year, I added a second. So now I've got two trees in the house. The main Christmas tree in our family room is just a mixture of ornaments and family ornaments. And, the theme is red basically, which is the same theme for my tree here, but I have been collecting Ariel and Little Mermaid ornaments for a few years now. And I think next year I'm going to add another tree in our basement and it's going to be a Little Mermaid tree. I haven't quite figured it out, but my husband's cousin and his aunt, like the mother and daughter, they do amazing Christmas trees at their house. I think they have something like 20 different trees in their house and each one has a different theme. They're really into it and they're beautiful. I can't wait to go to their house and see all their trees. I've seen pictures. I've never been able to walk through all the way because last year with, you know, pandemic and social distancing, I wasn't able to go see them. But this year, I'm excited to go walk through their house and see all of the trees. They sound just amazing. Let's see here. Thank you all for letting Jackie know about when the lives are. And welcome, Jackie. Thanks for joining us. Yes, it is a weekly live stream. It's Wednesday nights at 6 p.m. Mountain Time. And at least for the next few weeks until it's closer to the Christmas holiday. I think between Christmas and New Year, I'll probably take the week off. I won't have any videos. That'll be my little vacation. But other than that, I will be here every Wednesday live crafting with all of you. Oh, yay, Teresa. My glass board came in the mail today. I love it. Thank you for the coupon. It's like this mat that I'm working on now. Do you hear that with the clicking? It's glass and it's a wonderful glass mat. This one happens to be magnetic. So if you have a magnetic ruler, you can use it when you're cutting with an X-Acto knife. It's amazing. I love it. By the way, the coupon code that was just Christina30 to get 30% off. There's a regular everyday code that's Christina20 and that will give you 20% off. The 30% off was only valid through last night. It expired November 30th. So it's no longer valid, but you can still use Christina20 if you're wanting to get a glass mat. And if you do, I get a little bit of a commission. So thank you so much for using my code. Saves you guys a little money and helps me keep myself in craft supplies as well. Okay. Oh, yay. I love White Christmas. My favorite too. Sharon, it's so good. So, so good. So many people nowadays have never seen it, and I love introducing people to it who have never seen it. It's one of those movies that just, it's so heartwarming. I love it. Okay. Oh, yes. She was asking about lives, but yes, I do 3 videos per week. Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. The Wednesday ones are live. Okay, let's see here. Let's see here. Oh, good. Wendy says, I bought the same tree as you have in your craft room. Super cute. Yeah, it's a great tree. It's about 4.5 feet tall. It's perfect. Oh, thank you, Noelle. Yeah, they go right along with today's card, don't they? All right. I did mention, sorry, were asking about the nails. I did mention at the beginning that it is red nail polish with black stamping on top. If you've never heard of nail stamping, your mind is about to be blown. Just search on YouTube for nail stamping. Blow your mind. Okay. Della says, yes, I do change trees every year. I have ornaments for at least 4 themes. Wow. Wow. That's amazing that you have 4 different themes. That's awesome. Oh, that would be so fun. Melanie says she has a kitchen-themed tree and the eat-in portion of the kitchen. Oh, that would be so cute. I would love that. Oh, yes. That is such a great tradition, Kathy. She says, I try to get at least 1 new ornament each year. So when I decorate, it's a walk down memory lane. I love that. I love all the ornaments that have years on them. My mom gave us ornaments this year that it looks like it's the logo from the TV show Friends. And I don't know if you know this, but every one of the episodes of Friends, the title was the one with something or the one where whatever. And so the ornament looks like Friends and it says, has 2021. And then it says the one where we were all vaccinated. Oh, okay. Oh, Jackie, you are welcome. I'm here live. This is what the lives are all about. You get to chat back and forth. It's fun. Della says, do you like this mat better than the Tim Holtz one? I don't have the Tim Holtz one, so I can't compare directly. But the reason why I chose this one over the Tim Holtz one is because of the size. This size is, I think it's considerably larger than the Tim Holtz one. In fact, I think I might even buy the biggest one. There's one that's even larger than the one I've got going here. In fact, I will give you guys a little sneak peek. I will back out and you can see how big this mat is. It just keeps going and going and going. I can go back even more. Okay, there you go. Now you're getting the edges of my crafting space. That is how big this mat is. It is amazing. It's like the actual grid part is 22 by 16. So I think it's 18 by 24 actually, but it is an amazing mat. I love it so much. The Tim Holtz one does have the slick surface mat. It's actually this one right here that you can get a replacement for that you can just sit down here and it's not going to move. Like it doesn't want to budge. So you can sort of turn in and turn any glass mat into something similar to the Tim Holtz mat if you want. But yeah. All right. Yes. Love White Christmas and original Miracle on 34th Street. The original one. There's just something about that. I do like the one that they redid. Was it back in the late 90s maybe? Or mid 90s? I do like that one too. But the original, you just can't. Nothing can beat that. Jackie's asking what the purpose of a glass mat is. It's mostly for cleanup. It's a lot easier to clean a glass mat. Also, you can cut right into it with a knife and it's not going to damage it whatsoever. It's really great. Also, it's magnetic. You can have it be not magnetic when you order it from Glassboard Studio, but mine in particular is magnetic, which is kind of nice. I have a magnetic ruler hanging around here somewhere. And I pull it out for you right now, but I don't have it. But you can hold it and it's going to like keep it in place so you don't have anything shifting. You can also use your smaller magnets, like when you're using a stencil, you can put your magnets down to hold your project. So it's a nice kind of surface to work off of. Okay. Whoa, mind is blown. You searched nail stamping, didn't you? I love it. Sharon Meyer, I need to look nail stamping up. I normally do Lily and Fox nail wraps. Nail wraps are super fun and easy and they're just quick. I love that aspect of them. But I also like the process of painting my nails. So nail stamping is really fun. If you're looking for good nail stamping plates, check out Mo U London. They actually have a YouTube channel here too. But it's... Mo U London. I think that's what it is. And they have amazing stamping plates. The plaid pattern that I used today is from one of their plates. It's one of their trendsetter plates. Let's see. Oh, this sounds fun. We do a cookie exchange in our neighborhood. It's so fun to see all the different homemade cookies. That sounds amazing. We're doing something similar at my family party this year. Like every family's bringing a treat and we're going to just share them amongst ourselves. Let's see here. Oh, nice. Janie says, or maybe it's Janie, I'm not sure. I have 8 trees up at my house. I'm a Christmas-aholic. I love it. Okay. Scrolling through. Oh, that's cute. I'm putting up a teal tree in my craft room and putting crafty ornaments on it. Craft team ornaments? Craft tree ornaments? Probably craft tree ornaments on it. Love it. Oh, Chris is wondering what the white mat is for. This white mat is great for, okay, so when you're doing ink smushing with an ink pad, like you're smushing the ink pad directly down onto a hard surface so that the ink kind of pulls up and then you can use a bunch of different techniques with it. You want a slick surface. Now the glass would be great. However, on top of the black, you really couldn't see the color. So in that case, I'd pull this out and I would do all the ink smushing on this. So I do have a white mat, but I've moved it to a different section of my craft room because I like to film with a black mat. I think it looks a little better on camera. But I know people who love their white mat for crafting because they can see the color of everything. So it really just depends. Lori says, I didn't know I could cut on my glass mat. You know, I didn't know if I could or not, but I cut on it the other day and it didn't leave a mark or anything. So I think you're safe. Let's see here. Yes, Maniology does have great nail stamping plates. They do. So does Uber Chic Beauty and What's Up Nails. Both of the all those companies are great. Oh, craft items. Yes, craft items. How far in advance do you start designing holiday stencils, dyes, craft materials for the holidays? Generally in June. It's about 6 months out. All right. I think we're about wrapped up for the evening. Thank you all. And a special big thank you to those of you who sent a super chat. I appreciate you so much. I will be back on Friday with day 18 of the holiday card series. I have it filmed, but I'm thinking I might save it for another one and instead show something a little different. I don't know. I haven't decided yet. But it should be a good one. Thank you so much for joining me tonight. And I will see you in my next video. Have a great night.